Okay, so starting off, you can sell out club shows all around the world. Why do you keep coming back to Australia?
It's because you guys are too kind to us. It's I was saying yesterday that it's cool that we can keep coming back here and people are still into it because it's so good over here for us. Like everything about it, the shows are great and we just love being here in general. So you kind of get nervous right before because it's like, well, we've been there like 7 times. I think this is our 7th time. Like what if this is the time that we get over there and it's it, they're just over it. But they're not, so we're grateful.
Yep. Yeah. And I heard you've been taking down the barriers as well up the front, or?
Yeah.
Is that from your end or is that?
Yeah, it just makes it more fun, I think, and definitely a lot safer. I think that promoters feel like it's safer for the kids if they have a barricade, but it's not because they just fall over it and the security guards can't keep up and they drop them. I mean, the first show we had was in Brisbane and there's a barricade and like 3 kids fell on their head. I saw it. And without the barricade, people just kind of take care of each other.
Yeah. So with this album tour cycle, last 18 months, how is it compared to the previous albums you've done?
I don't know. This feels like this one's just so much more of a whirlwind. I don't know if we're actually touring more on this one or if it just feels like it because we're getting older. But it just feels like it's nonstop with this one. But it's good because we were discussing it the other day, trying to put the set list together. And there's songs on the new record that we haven't even played live yet, and we're like, oh, we'll have to break them out next tour. And then we're like, wait a minute, next tour is going to be like on a new record, so it's already. I feel like I wish we had more time to tour on this one, but
yeah. And I've been going back through your albums and listening to a lot of the older ones, and it seems from album to album, you're not afraid to take a risk. Now, does that explain your longevity in the music business?
I think so. I mean, if anything explains it, I would guess it's that. It's trying to just keep fresh, keep the kids interested. I mean, it's definitely easy to kind of do what you know you can do and rest on your laurels that way and know that you're gonna have like a built-in amount of people at every show, but that's just not exciting. I mean, it's exciting for us to try something new and see how people react, and then if they don't like it, we don't have to do it anymore.
Yeah.
I mean, unless it's something that we love, but for the most part, it's just us, you know, trying to keep it new.
Yep. And you've been playing Hot Damn in full a lot. How does it come across live 10 years on?
It's different. It's very different for me. It was like, I mean, I was so young and my voice was so much different back then. So it's honestly hard for me to do some of those songs now. It's just like in a different, I mean, I guess register or something. It's just so much like, I don't know how I did it. There were so many lyrics. I was just shoving in so many lyrics in those old songs. I don't know what I was thinking, but it's tiring.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's fine.
And I suppose it's a tricky thing with the 10-year anniversary albums because it's sort of, it's a nice nostalgic thing, but then it doesn't pay as much respect to the albums that you don't
right.
do. Is that something you've had to balance out a bit? Or?
Well, yeah, because when we were doing it, we were doing a normal set and then playing Hot Damn. So, you know, we understand that. Like, people that come to the shows aren't going to really want to, if they do want to see the record, that's the only people that are going to come out, you know, like people that might like our newer stuff aren't going to go to a show that you're only playing old stuff at. So, we actually did pretty much 2 shows each night. It was a regular set, and then it was Hot Damn. And if people wanted to leave, they could leave. And if they wanted to stick around and see the old stuff.
Did you have to change anything around in sort of the song structures and that because they didn't come across?
No. So, I mean, you mean like revising them like to play them live again?
Yeah, or even Andy changing up little bits or anything like that?
I don't think so. No, I really don't think so. We pretty much try to keep it true. I mean, it's not ours to reinterpret anymore. I mean, we put it out there and, you know, I just kind of wanted to keep it as true to form as possible.
Yeah. Is it hard to back up your live performance every night?
Yeah. it's very hard. But it just becomes something that you got to do. And, if you want it to work, you just have to do it. There's no other option.
Yeah, so. And I read somewhere that last year or something, you played 290 shows in the year or something like that.
Yeah.
Is that sustainable forever or for the next decade? Or?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's you get older and you think, oh, time off would be nice, but it's not getting impossible. I mean, I can do it. We can all do it. You know, it's we're just a little more out of breath, but it's definitely still possible. It's sustainable for sure.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know for how long. Nobody's broken any bones yet, but we'll see.
Have you been riding on the road recently? Or?
Andy has. Yeah, Andy's been riding a lot. I think that the guys are just going over some new stuff together because that's kind of, once we get into the mode of writing an album. Think, you know, we'll use sound checks and stuff to sort of run shit by each other. So we're kind of in that mode right now. So yeah, they're right.
Yep. Is there a live DVD in the works or something that's...
I don't know, nothing planned. I mean, the guy that does our DVDs, Doug Spangenberg, is just... We just like having him out. So, I mean, I'm sure he'll come out with us, probably to the studio or something. It's just good to give people something else, you know? It's, you know, now that you can just click a button on a piece of glass and have an album in your hand, it's... You need something more. You need, you know, something that's tangential to the album.
So. Yeah, so I suppose then... Music aside, how much effort goes into, you know, the artistic side of Every Time I Die, such as album artwork, on stage?
A lot. Yeah.
Visuals.
I think. Well, I mean, as far as like the visuals part of it, it's almost like less is more with us now because things are. I mean, bands are getting out of control, and you know, the bigger the bands, the more production they have, and I think it's kind of. I don't know. I think it's kind of our thing to be as minimal as possible. It's just a show.
Is that like having a subtle dig at all those other bands that have such big productions?
No, because I would love to do it. You know, if we get here, I would love to do it, but we just don't have the money.
And what are you listening to right now? What other bands are you sort of getting in on?
I was listening.
Sorry, guys.
New Balance and Composure is great. What else? What do you got?
New Twitching Tongues record. It's awesome.
Whatever it is you're wearing is what I've been smelling.
Yeah.
It smells very good.
Gorilla yeah. Perfume.
Yeah. I've been smelling it and I just thought it was like the scent of Australia, but it's Andy. Yeah.
And I saw a Dr. Pepper commercial on YouTube a few months ago.
Yeah.
Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
They literally hit me up on Twitter. It was like their company, their promotion company, like they hire out.
Yep.
And they're just like, yeah, my client wants to use you. And I literally thought they were going to... asked me to be like a biker or something like that in something, and then they're like, no, they want to do like a little piece on you.
So you put some headshots out there, or
no, never.
No,
did anything
so
like
not
that.
Trying to get a gig on Sons of Anarchy, or
not Sons of Anarchy, but I don't know, maybe Queer Eye for the Straight Guy, something like that.
And I saw, are you into Violent Soho? Or
I love Violent Soho, dude. The minute I made that tweet, I've gotten asked more questions about that. Made one little tweet.
Have you seen a clip for In the Aisle or?
No, dude, that new record is fucking genius though.
Yep. And I suppose what else is planned for 2013? Just touring or?
Yeah, we're gonna start writing. I don't know if we'll actually come together to start writing very much before the new year, but as soon as the new year hits, we're gonna really dig in.
Like, we all have shit. It's just, we don't all have shit together.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I suppose now, are you married or?
Yep.
So it's, obviously that's hard to juggle as well.
Yeah, and yeah, it gets difficult.
Jordan was out here earlier beforehand for a few weeks, or
yep. Yeah. I don't know. I don't know for how long, but yeah, he was out here for a bit.
Awesome. Well, thanks for speaking to AMH TV.
Absolutely.
For 2 seconds.
Yeah.